Hello everyone. Today's topic is mesh analysis of the subject network theory. In last lecture, I have discussed about nodal analysis. So, in circuit analysis, simple circuits can be analyzed by using the basic analyzing tools like Ohm's law, KVL, and KCL. But for a complex circuit that consists of various independent and dependent sources, what we can do is we can apply nodal analysis to find out the node voltages. Then you can calculate or you can find out the value of branch currents also. Now there is another method that is called mesh analysis or loop analysis, by which we can find out the mesh currents and the branch currents. Knowing that, we can find out the value of voltage drop across the any branch, across any branch. Now mesh is, if you remember, mesh is nothing but a loop that does not consist of any other loop inside. Now in nodal analysis, we apply Kirchhoff's current law, but in case of mesh analysis, we have to apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay, so in mesh analysis, we will consider the currents flowing through each mesh. That is the first point. Hence, mesh analysis is also called mesh current method. Now, a branch is nothing but a path that joins two nodes, and it contains a circuit element. Now, if a branch belongs to only one mesh, then the branch current will be equal to the mesh current. And if a branch is common to two meshes, then the branch current will be equal to the sum or difference of the two mesh currents, depend on the direction of the mesh currents. Now let us take the steps. Now procedure of mesh analysis is, first step is we have to identify all the meshes and we have to assign mesh currents in either clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. Now for a particular solution, we have to assign all the mesh currents in either clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. We cannot use both at the same circuit. Now after that, we have to observe the amount of current that flows through each element in terms of mesh currents. Then we have to write the mesh equation, or we have to write the KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law equations, to all the meshes. After that, we have to solve those mesh equations in order to get the mesh currents. Now those are the basic steps. Now let us see with an example. Now suppose we have to find out the voltage across this 30 ohm resistor using mesh analysis. Now this is a circuit. Now in this circuit, what we have to first find out, how many meshes are there. So it is very clear that we have two meshes. Okay, first mesh current assuming as I1, second one I2, and we are taking this direction is clockwise direction for both the mesh. Now for this problem, or for a particular problem, if you assign mesh current as clockwise, all the meshes you have to assign clockwise. You can do it here, another one as anti-clockwise. You have to follow that procedure. Now after assigning the mesh current, we have to write KVL across. We have to write KVL for each mesh. Okay, so we have two mesh, mesh 1, mesh 2. Mesh current is I1, I2. So you have to write KVL along this mesh 1 loop, and then mesh KVL equation along this loop 2 or mesh 2. So now we have to write the mesh equation. Now we can follow some process. One process is, when writing KVL along a loop, current is direction is upward. For this branch, current direction is upward and voltage is nothing but minus to plus, so it is increasing. So you can consider as plus 20 volt. Or we can think of that this is this current direction is entering first at negative terminal, so we can consider as minus 20. Then plus minus, it encounter plus first, so plus 5 into I1, again plus 10 into I1 minus I2. Like that way you can do also. So first, what we are doing here for this problem, we are taking that this is an clockwise direction, so it is going up, so it is going from minus to plus, so voltage rise, so 20 volt. So plus 20, then in resistor voltage drop, so we can consider as minus, negative. So here this is minus 5 into I1, because this resistance is only for mesh 1. It is a part of mesh 1 only, that is the mesh current I1. So current through this branch is only I1, so 5I1. Now for this 10 ohm resistor, we can see there is a current flowing I1 and another current is flowing I2. These two currents are flowing through this 10 ohm resistor, and this, as we are taking I1 as mesh 1 as a reference, so what we are doing is I1 is going downward, I2 is going upward, so I1 minus I2, so 20 minus 5 I1 minus 10 into I1 minus I2. Now if we solve it, we will get one equation. Okay. Now for second loop, what we can see that this is 10 I2 minus I1 minus 10 I2 minus I1 for resistance, there is a voltage drop. And according to this direction, here the current is going downward for this branch, so going minus to plus, so positive. So here minus 10 I2 minus I1 minus 30 I2, because here only I2 current is flowing, plus 80 equal to 0. If we solve, we will get equation 2. So here, when we are considering mesh 1, we are taking this current as I1 minus I2. When we are considering mesh 2, we are considering I2 minus I1. So which mesh is the reference? That current we are taking is the first one, I1, and here it is I2. And here it is I2. Okay. So after we are getting two equations, I1 and I2, two unknown, so we can solve it and we can get the value of I1 and I2. Okay, so we got the value of I1 and I2. Now the main point is, what we have to find out? Voltage drop across 30 ohm. Now through 30 ohm, what is the current that is flowing? That is only I2. So that will be I2 into 30. Now if we have to find out voltage drop across 10 ohm resistor, then it will be I1 minus I2 into 30, 10, or I2 minus I1 into 10. Okay. So in this case, voltage drop across 30 ohm resistor is I2 into R. So we got the voltage drop across 30 ohm resistor. Now from the above example, what we can conclude that we have to solve m mesh equations if we have m number of meshes. Okay. Now we can choose either nodal analysis or mesh analysis for the circuit analysis, to do circuit analysis. Now in that case, which one is better, that is quite debatable. In that case, what we have to do is, suppose we have to find out node voltages, then go for nodal analysis. If you have to find out branch currents or say mesh current, then it will be better for mesh analysis. But another thing you can consider, that how many equation you will get from a circuit, if you want to solve it using nodal, how many equation you will get, or mesh, how many equation, which one has the lesser number of equation to solve, that will be the better choice. Okay. So in this case, for this circuit, say we have two mesh equations, so two equation. Now if you want to solve this circuit by nodal analysis, if this one is grounded, what happened? This voltage is plus 20 volt and this voltage is minus 80 volt. Only you have to find out one node voltage. So that will be the better one. Okay. So this is how we can analyze. Now let us take another example, example 2. Okay. Now say you have to kind of find out the voltage across the 12 ohm current source. Across this 12 ohm current source, what is the voltage using mesh analysis? Okay. So in that problem, what we can do that here we have how many meshes? 1, 2, 3 meshes. Now, if this is the mesh I1, so I1 current is nothing but, suppose a current source is present in a mesh, and this current source is connected to only single mesh. Okay. Then whatever the current value, that will be equal to the mesh current. That means here I1 will become 12 I1. Okay. Now we can apply some other technique also. That means here we have current source in parallel with voltage resistor, that we can convert this current source with parallel with a resistor, we can convert that into voltage source in series with resistor. That is source transformation. Let us apply that. So 4 ohm 4 ampere resistor current, 4 ohm resistor, then what is the voltage? That is Is into Rs, that so 16 volt, V equal to I into R. So 16 volt voltage source in series with 4 ohm resistor, that is the source conversion from current to voltage source, that we can apply here. Okay. So instead of current source and resistance, we are having now a voltage source with resistance. So this circuit becomes this. So we have two meshes and clockwise direction. So this I1 will be equal to nothing but 12 ampere, I1 will be equal to 12 ampere, because this is the current source and this I1 is same as this 12 ampere. Now say you have to write KVL across this mesh 1. Now we are assuming voltage across this current source is Vx. Okay. So we are taking Vx minus 6 into I1 minus I2, because I1 is flowing downward, I2 is flowing in 6 ohm resistor upward. So I1 minus I2, then again plus 2 minus this way. So plus 2 minus voltage drop, so minus 18. I1 equal to 12 ampere, that already we got. So we get Vx in and I2 as the equation 1. Now for mesh 2, if you write the KVL equation, what will be that? I2 is going upward, so voltage increases 18, 6 into I2 minus I1 minus voltage drop across the resistor. Here it is 4 ohm resistor, and on mesh current is nothing but only I2, because this is connected to single mesh. 4 I2, now here plus 2 minus, and here the direction is downward, plus 2 minus, so voltage drop minus 16. Now what we got, another from this I1. If I1 is known, we can get the value of I2. If we got I2, we can put it here, we can find out Vx. So we got value of Vx, that is the voltage drop across the current source, 12 ampere current source. Now say another example. Now in that case, say you have to find out the voltage across the current source, so this one, and current flowing through A and A to C, I of AC, A to C. Now we have got what we can say, that if you write KVL for mesh 1, now 3 meshes are there, mesh 1, mesh 2, mesh 3, and mesh currents are I1, I2, I3. Okay, so if you write KVL for mesh 1, voltage is increasing minus to plus, so V1. Now here 2 ohm through this 2 ohm resistor, what is the current flowing? I1 going left side to right side, and I3 is going right to left. So what you can write? I1 minus I3. Then R4, I1 is going downward, I2 going upward, so I1 minus I2. So you get one equation. Now if we want to apply KVL at second loop, we have to find out voltage drop across this current source. So this is say plus minus, and now if we go by clockwise direction, then we are going plus to minus, so minus Vc, voltage across this current source, then across voltage drop across R4 is minus I2 minus I1. R4 into I2 minus I1. Then here for R3, I2 is flowing from left to right, and I3 is flowing from right to left. So I2 minus I3. So R3 into I2 minus I3. So you can solve it. And here, what is the value of I2? Now we are taking I2 is nothing but minus 2 ampere. So minus 2 ampere. So if you put this value of I2 here, you will get VC equation with respect to I1, I3. Now you have to apply KVL at mesh 3. So here that is 2 into I3 minus I1 minus 4 into I3 minus R3 into I2 minus I3 minus I2. So minus R1 into I3 minus R3 into I2 minus I3 minus R2 into I3 minus I1. And if you solve it by putting I2 equal to minus 2 ampere, we will get I1 and I3 value. Then we can find out the value of VC from here by putting I1, I3 value. So that is the voltage drop across this current source. And what is the current flowing IAC? So current flow from I, current flow, that is I of AC. So current flowing from I position YA to C through this 2 ohm resistor. That is from left to right side. That will be what? I1 minus I3. Because I1 is flowing left to right and I3 is flowing right to left. So I1 minus I3. So that IAC is nothing but I1 minus I3. So you get the IAC value. Now there is another type of problem, just like super node. Suppose we have a circuit in which we have 3 meshes. Okay. And if a current source is common for connect, if there is a current source that is common to 2 meshes, then what happened? If you want to write the KVL, you can write across voltage rise or voltage drop, across resistance voltage drop, resistance voltage drop, or across current source, what is the voltage drop? That we cannot write directly. So we cannot apply KVL if a current source is a common factor for 2 meshes. If it is for a single mesh, then mesh current will be equal to the current source value. You have to take care of the direction. Okay. Whenever the current source is common for 2 meshes, we cannot write KVL, so we have to form a super mesh. What we have to do? We have to remove this current source or that particular branch. Okay. And we have to take mesh 1, mesh 2 all together, make a one super mesh, and we have to apply one KCL at particular node, either the top node or at bottom node. We have to write KCL. Just like super node, what we are doing in the super node, we are merging 2 nodes together and we are applying KVL at super node. Here what we have to do, we have to merge the 2 meshes. If one current source is common to 2 meshes, we have to merge the 2 meshes by removing the current source or that particular branch. We have to form a super mesh, merging of 2 meshes, and we have to write KCL at any of the node of the current source. Okay. So this is how we have to solve. So now we have to remove this. Now see here, we have removed this branch totally and we are writing KVL across this super mesh. Okay. Across this whole mesh. That is the merging of mesh 1 and mesh 2. Okay. So if you write KVL to the super mesh, what we will get? Voltage is increasing, so V, then minus, so I am taking on the right hand side, left. So what will happen? That is I1 is flowing through R1, so I1 R1, and I2 minus I3 is flowing through R3. So that is I1 R1 plus I2 minus I3 into R3. Okay. So you will get the equation. That is the KVL equation of super mesh. Now you can write mesh for mesh 3 also, that is minus R3 into I3 minus I2 and I3 into R4. Both are minus, so equal to 0, so you can make it positive. Now what we have to do is we have to write KCL at this node, or what is the value of this current source. Okay, this current source value will be what? Say this is I. So I will be equal to what? Nothing but I1 is going downward, I2 going upward. So I will be equal to what? I1 minus I2. So you can see here I equal to I1 minus I2. Now let us take one example of that. Use the super mesh concept, solve to find out Vx across this resistance. Now what happened? If you want to apply mesh analysis, two meshes are there, one M1, M2. So two mesh current I1, I2 in an clockwise direction of current. Now here you can see we can write the KVL. If you want to write KVL for mesh 1, voltage drop, but across this current source we cannot write voltage drop directly. So what you have to do, we have to make super mesh. That means we have to remove this current source and we have to form a super mesh by merging M1, M2, mesh 1, mesh 2 together. So this is the super mesh now. Now for super mesh, if you want to write the equation, what we will write? I1 into 1, right? 2 into I1, that is 1 plus 2 into I1, then 2 plus 4 into I2, 2 plus 4 into I2 equal to 0. If both are minus also, then if you equate, that will be 0, equal to 0 only. That will become positive. Now what you have to do? You have to find out KCL equation. You have to write a KCL equation, which is also known as auxiliary equation from the super mesh. Now this I 3 ampere current is what? Nothing but I1 is going downward, but I2 is going upward. That means I2 minus I1 equal to 3. I2 minus I1 equal to 3 ampere. So always you have to take care of the current source direction. So I2 is going upward, so I2, I1 subtracted equal to I3. Now we can solve these two equation. We have two unknowns and we can get I1, I2 value. Then what is the Vx? Nothing but 4 into I2. So 4 I2, so we get the value. So see another example of super mesh analysis. Now see, in this case what happened? We have 1 mesh, 2, 3, 4. 4 meshes are there. Now for mesh 1, what we can see, this there is a current source. Now this current source is connected to a single mesh. It is not a common factor for 2 meshes. That means whatever this value, that will be equal to the mesh current value, because this I1 is flowing through this. So I1 equal to 2 ampere. Similarly here I3 equal to minus 3 ampere. Why? Because this I3 is going downward, I3 is going, this 3 ampere is going upward, so minus 3 ampere. And if you want to write KVL across this mesh 2 and 4, we cannot write KVL because we cannot find out voltage drop across this 4 ampere current source. Then we have to make super mesh, merging mesh 2 and mesh 4, then writing the KVL equation. So that is 6 into I2 minus I1, 12 I4, 6 into I3 minus I2, I2 minus I3, 6 I2 minus I3, all are minus sign, so equal to 0, so that can be written as all are as positive. Now what happened? We have to write the auxiliary equation for this current source, which is common to two meshes, for this super mesh. Now here 4 ampere current, that will be what? I4 is going from right to left side, I2 is left to right side. 4 ampere is going right to left. So that is I4 minus I2 equal to, I4 minus I2 equal to 4 ampere. Now we can solve it. So you know value of I1 and I3. You can put it here and you can solve to get the value of I2 and I4. Okay. Now this is one example problem with dependent source. Now you can say there is two meshes, mesh 1, mesh 2, two mesh current, I1, I2. And if you write, now you have to write there is no current source, so you don't have to think about super mesh and all. So for mesh 1, if you want to write this, now here how this is written, just like that I1, this current is first encountered to the negative terminal, so minus 12. We can write this as plus also, because minus to plus voltage is increasing. Okay, and here minus minus, but here what happened, it is encounter minus plus to minus 12, then it is encountered plus, so plus 2 into I1, again it is encountered to plus first, so plus 4 I1 minus I2. If you write opposite way, that is 12 plus 12 minus 2 I1 minus 4 I1 minus I2. So both are almost the same thing. Okay. The sign different, minus become plus, plus become minus. So we can write opposite way also. Now for 4 mesh 2, that is plus, what we can write? I2 4 into I2 minus I1, and here it is encountered to positive terminal first, so plus 2Vx equal to 0. Now here, whenever there is a dependent source, we must write the another auxiliary equation, that is the unknown variable of the dependent source, which is here Vx. Now Vx is where? Here, plus minus. So this value is what? Nothing but V across a resistor. What is the value? V equal to IR. What is the current flowing through? This I1, that is 2 into I1. So we can put the Vx value here and we can solve these two equations. We will get I1, I2 as well as value of Vx. Similarly, third problem, another problem, we have three mesh currents I1 and 2 I3, and we can write the mesh equation. Now, in this case, what happened? This is going upward, we first encoded minus, so minus 2, then 0.1 I1, okay. Then 0.5 into I1 minus I3, then plus 0.1 into I1 minus I2. First equation, from mesh 2, plus 0.1 I2 minus I1, 0.5 I2 minus I3, then 0.1 I2, then it encountered plus sign before, so plus 3. For mesh 3 again, you can write the same equation. We will get I1, I2, I3, solve it, you will get I1 and I3, and value of Ix, Ix is this current, that is nothing but going downward, I1 is going downward, so Ix equal to I1 minus I2. I is equal to I1 minus I2, that you can find out. Okay. Now what we can do is, here we can find out a matrix method to solve also. Okay. That means what? For I1, what is the value? 0.1, 0.5, 0.1, all are plus. And for I3, I2 having minus. Minus 0.5, minus 0.1. That means for I1 is flowing through which are the branches, 0.1, 0.5, 0.1, addition of that. I2 is flowing also through this 0.1 ohm, that will be in negative sign, with negative sign. I3 also flowing through 0.5 ohm, that will be negative sign. So that way we can write matrix method by inspection. That we will solve one problem later on. So similarly, this is another problem. Here what happened? Here I2 is nothing but minus 4 ampere, because I2 is going clockwise. So here it is downward, but 4 ampere upward, so minus 4 ampere. I3 is going left to right, but 2 ampere going right to left, so it is minus 2. And we can write this plus 0.5 I1 minus 6 volt plus 0.5 I1 minus I2. And Ix equal to what? Nothing but I1 minus I2. So you know the value of Ix, you can find out by solving. Okay. So again, another problem. Here what we can observe is three meshes. Okay. And there is a voltage source plus minus, but current control 2Y. Okay. So for first mesh, it is encountered negative terminal first, to minus 8, then plus 1 into I1, plus 2 into I1 minus I3, then 1 into I1 minus I2. Okay. So similarly, if you make it matrix method, what you can write, for I1 that resistance is 2 plus 1 plus 1. Okay. For I2 that is minus 1, I2 equal to minus 1. And I3 equal to minus 2. minus 2. For second, this is going 1 into I2 minus I1, then this is encountered here first. So minus 2i plus 6 I2 minus I3 and 1 I2. Now for this case, what happened? I1 is minus 1. For I1, it is minus 1, 1 into this. So minus 1. I2 is nothing but 2 plus 6 plus 1. So that is 8. 6, 1 and 1. For I3, that is minus 6. Plus minus 6. Okay. For I3 also, you can write the similarly the equation. And here this I is nothing but I1 minus I2, which is the controlling current. So I equal to I1 minus I2. This is the auxiliary equation that we got from the dependent source. This term you can put it here wherever there is a 2i. 2i and here also 2i. We can put I1 minus I2 here and we can solve this equation to get I1, I2, I3 and Vx. Now there is another. So here we have four meshes. We have to find out say I0, which is nothing but I3 going downward, I4 going upward. So I3 minus I4. So we are writing this three equation for four mesh equation. Okay. Then we have to solve to get the result. I0 equal to nothing but I3 minus I4. Now this is another type of problem. Here let me use some other technique also merged with this mesh analysis. That is, we have a 12 volt source in series with 6 ohm resistor, right? That we can convert using source transformation to current source. Because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 meshes, right? So let us reduce that number of meshes. How? This voltage source in series with resistance, so convert into current source. So that will be what? I equal to 12 V by R. So 12 by 6, that is 2. So 2 ampere in parallel with 2 ampere current source parallel with 6 ohm resistor, which is again parallel with 6 ohm. So two similar same value of resistance, if it is parallel, that will become R by 2. So it becomes 3 ohm. Okay. Now again, I'm converting this into voltage source. So the voltage source value will be what? 3 V equal to IR. I is 2, R is 3. So 6 volt in series with 3 ohm resistor. So it becomes 6 ohm. Now again, converting this 6 volt and 6 ohm resistor to current source. Then what will happen? 6 volt divided by 6 ohm. I equal to V by R, so it will be 1 ampere in parallel with 6. Now this 2 6 ohm parallel resistance, it will give you 3 ohm resistor. If you convert into with 1 ampere current source, if you convert into voltage source, that will be 3 volt with 3 ampere, a 3 ohm resistor. So what happened? Now we have only 3 meshes. Previously we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 meshes. Now just doing the source conversion, voltage current source to current source, current to voltage source, we reduce to 3. Now say we have to solve it by inspection. For I1, what is the value? For I1, so what happened is, we have to write how many variables with respect to I1, I2, I3 equal to the constant term here. Okay, and here we have to write the resistance value. Now for I1 is going through 3 ohm, 3 ohm, 4 ohm. So 3, 3, 4. 3 plus 3 plus 4, that is the for I1. I2 is flowing through this 3 ohm resistor. I2 and I1 both are flowing. So that comes as minus of that. So only R11, resistance R11, that is the I1 current flowing through the mesh 1. R1, R2, R12, that is the common resistance between mesh 1 and 2, that will come with respect to minus sign. Again, 1 and 3 that are connected together, the common resistance is 4, so that will come as minus sign. So same mesh means positive, all positive value, and the resistance value that is common to two meshes, that will have negative value. Now say for I2, what are the current, what are the value? 3. First value here you have to write as I1. Now for this loop mesh, R3 ohm resistance is the common between mesh 1 and mesh 2. So what you can write? Minus 3. Then I2 is flowing through 3 plus 4 plus 1. So 3 plus 4 plus 1. And between mesh 2 and 3, the common factor is 1 ohm resistor with negative sign. Similarly for I3, first we have to write the I1. Between mesh 1 and 3, what is the common? R resistance value 4 with minus sign. Between mesh 2, mesh 3, common is 1, so minus 1. And for I3 is showing these three resistance, 4, 3 and 1. So those are added together. And what is the constant value? Here the constant value is 3 volt, right? But here we don't have any constant value because there is no voltage source. So 300. Then we can solve it by Cramer's rule, I1, I2, I3. Okay. Now let me just show you that method again using this problem. Now for mesh 1, what happened? We have R11. For mesh 1, what are the resistance? 10 and 5. So total is plus 15. R12. So common between mesh 1 and 2, that means that is 10 ohm, that will come with negative sign. R13. 1 and 3, there is no common factor, so that will be 0. Now R22, that means for mesh 2, what are the resistances? 10 plus 10 plus 5, that is 25. R12, 10 is the common with negative sign. That is R23, minus 10. And R21 is also minus 10. R12 is minus 10. R21 also minus 10. R23 also minus 10. Now R33 is 10 plus 15. Okay. And here voltage is 21 volt. Here there is no voltage, so 0. And here the voltage is 4.2 volt. So then we can write the matrix form. That is R11, R12. R13, R21, R22, R23, R31, R32, R33, I1, I2, I3 and the constant term V mesh T1, mesh 1, mesh 2, mesh 3, and we can solve it by Cramer's rule. Okay. Now there is another problem that here it is very easy because I1 is flowing through this path, so I1 is nothing but 4 milliampere, and this current source is not common to two meshes, single mesh, so mesh current will be just value of the current source. I2 is also minus 2 ampere because direction is opposite here. Okay. So now we have to write mesh 3 KVL across this. So what we can write? That it is encountered minus first, so minus 3 volt, then plus 4 I3 minus I2, 2 plus 2 I3 minus I1 plus 6k into I3. So you get the value of I3 directly. Find V0, voltage drop across this terminal. What you can write? That you can apply a KVL here. So that is, it is encounter plus first, so 3 volt minus I3 into 3 plus 3 volt KVL across this loop, that is plus 3 volt minus 6V3, then plus V0. So V0 equal to, you can find out the value. Now here the main point that you have to remember is, just let me just show you the Cramer's rule quickly. So consider Cramer's rule is, consider the linear system, say AX plus BY equal to E, CX plus DY equal to X. So in matrix form, how we can write? X and Y is the variable, X and Y, and the term coefficients are A, B, C, D, and constants are E and F. So how you can find out the value of X? To find out value of X, we have to find out determinant del 1 by del. So first, this determinant del, that is nothing but the value of this matrix. Okay. That is A, B, C, D. How to find out? A into D minus B into C. And to find out determinant 1, delta 1, what you have to do is for x, the first row we have to replace it by the constant term. So EF, instead of AB, we have to write EF and BD divided by the determinant term, you will get x. To find out y, we have to replace this second column by the constant term. Okay, this is the for two equation. Now for three equations, we have this ax by plus cz equal to j. So we have parameter abc, then def ghi with respect to xyz constant term jkl. Then we have to find out del 1 and del. Okay, now to find out del 1 and del, let me just show you one easy method. That is, say for this example, to find out del, what you have to do, the particular matrix we have to take to find out del, the coefficient term of the variable without replacing the constant term. To find out the value of v1, we have to replace the first column. To find out v2, we have to replace the second column. To find out v3, you have to replace the third column by the constant term. Now here what you have to do is we have the values, and after that we have to write the first two rows we have to include here. Okay, then we have to multiply diagonally three times. Okay, this is one multiplication, and it has to multiply by plus sign. Here also plus sign, here also plus sign. We are multiplying three times. Okay, so what is the value? 7 into 3, 21 into 1 into plus, that means plus 21, minus 4 into minus 3, that is plus 12, minus 12 into plus, so that will be minus 12. 2 into 4 minus 4, so that will be plus 4 into plus, that plus 4. This is the three times you have to do. Then again we have to do the cross one. You have to make this particular pattern cross one. You have to multiply, and here you have to multiply by negative sign. That means 7 into 14 into 1 minus 14 into minus, so plus 14. Okay. 3 into 3, 9 into 1 minus minus plus into minus, so minus 9, and minus minus plus 8 into minus, so minus 8. And if you do the summation, you will get the determinant value. Now to find out delta 1, what happened? We have to replace this first column by the constant term. So I have replaced this 1200, and you have to write these first two rows again, and then there is a diagonally you have to multiply three times, 1, 2, 3 times, and here you have to multiply by plus, and again from the right hand side you have to diagonally you have to multiply three times, and here you have to multiply it by minus sign. So 12 and 7, 84 plus, so plus 84. Now for next one is 0, 0, so that will be 0, 0, no problem. Next one is again 0, so 0. Now after that, 12 into 3, 36, minus minus plus into minus, so minus 36, 0 into something is 0. So you will get this value. So delta 1 by delta, that will give you V1. Similarly, we can replace second row by 1200 here, and repeat the first two rows and cross multiplication. Here it is with plus, and here it will be multiplication diagonally with negative, multiply again by negative. So this is how you can solve it easily. Okay, you can follow this method also to solve the Cramer's rule. And lastly, the main points you have to remember for mesh analysis is that you have to assign meshes and assign mesh current. I1, give the name I1, I2, I3, and if there is a current source, only one current source is part of only one mesh, then whatever the current source value, that will be equal to the mesh current. So that is very easily done. Okay. Now if current source is part of two mesh, then you have to form a super mesh by removing the current source. You have to write the KVL, and you have to apply a KCL at the super mesh. That means for the current source, that is at this top node or at bottom node. that means 2 ampere current is going up. Now here I2 is going up, so I2 minus I1 equal to 2 ampere. That is the auxiliary equation or extra equation that we got. So this is the technique that is known as mesh analysis with super mesh analysis if there is current source common to or part of two meshes. Okay, so now we can practice and try to solve as many problem as possible. So that's it. Thank you so much.